very esteemed audience. Mm-hmm.
Sure.
So, this is my OLP about the vertebrae of the skeleton and the spine. And I did this because I wanted to increase my knowledge in anatomy and physiology, and like just because I want to be a doctor. So the last MLP I did was about like 7 to 8 drawings of the muscular system, like the torsos and thing, the arms and legs. So this time I did the spine to get more knowledge. And then there's like lumbar vertebrae, this. There's like 5 of them apparently. This is the pelvic region where it supports or is adapted to hold more weight than any other vertebrae. So these little spaces right there.
Yeah.
Right here. Yeah, you can. The little spaces kind of like thing that separate them are masses of fibrocartilage called intervertebral discs. This is my LLP of the spine, generally. So, anyways, the intervertebral discs help cushion the vertebrae from breaking or fracturing or whatever, and it will help people walk or run. So, one challenge I faced was like, how do I create this single one that I did not know how to create that? So my mom helped me through that challenge, thankfully, and I was being discouraged at that point. And this is Tinkercad, which is a very simple 3D printing program, especially compared to others like Blender. So after I created one of these and the 5 vertebrae and the final, for the first vertebrae, I wanted to test a 3D printer to see if it would be good or not. So I tested it, it was good. So I moved on to the 5. So I wanted to see if that was going to be good or if I needed to adjust the vertebrae a little bit. And then the final project, there was a little challenge being, and we were at MADE, which is a very amazing place. You can like do all sorts of things like woodwork, laser cuts, 3D print, so on. Very amazing. So their printers can only like reach up to a height of something, I don't even know the height, but it cannot reach 186 millimeters, which is like 6 inches tall. So that was a problem, but Ethan helped me with that. He decided to lay it on flat on its side to see if that would work. However, it like got a little messed up and I broke it afterwards, sadly. So after that, I decided to reduce the height by like, and then there's a little black thing to reduce the height and adjust it. And then another challenge was copying the vertebrae from the anatomy books, because it's very detailed and very complicated, especially when you draw too. But anyways, I learned to never give up, and if you put your mind to something, it will eventually lead to success if you have positive output or positive attitude. So I learned more about Tinkercad itself, about the 3D printing process. So if you are curious, you have to press export and then push whatever file you're going to do. In this case, I think I did STL, maybe. And then I sent it to Ethan. He 3D printed the thing and then watched magic. Very cool. And then I learned more about the spine and what the bones are and how they worked. So that's my MLP presentation. I would like to thank Howard for being my mentor and helping me through the MLP
different types of vertebrae and how they look? How did you modify the basic shape to show that?
So I like tweaked it a little bit. That compared to the other ones, which are like a little wider kind of, and or skinnier sometimes, and it's just different sizes and how they work differently. Like the lumbar is adapted to hold more weight compared to the torso type of vertebrae, and so I just tried making it smaller somewhat. Not that. Let's imagine that got smaller. So it got smaller, and then I did that for